After several homeless sweeps that spanned months, we noticed tents returning to Kakaako. The state has a long-term solution, but one lawmaker is pushing what he says would be a quick fix to clear the streets. Bridget Namata went back to that area today and joins us now with more. Bridget?
Hi, Kathy. The first sweep started back in October. Since then, the majority of the encampment has cleared out, but there were stragglers popping up in nearby Kakaako Waterfront Park and Kiwalo Basin, and now back in the same area that was first cleared out off Cooke Street and Ala Moana Boulevard.
The tents are back, says one family heading to nearby Children's Discovery Center.
You know, when we see sweeps all over the city, they'll just go and come back the next day, so I'm not really surprised.
You can see across the street, it's as if the homeless camp never left. I counted well over 20 tents. I noticed one pet dog, and there appears to be a family or a group of friends gathering by one of the tents.
I reached out to Tracy and Tabitha Martin, a former homeless couple now renting a home in Pacific Heights. They left Kakaako on December 5th, but they regularly visit their former neighbors.
These people are people from Hawaii, you know, not much mainland people. It's local people.
Tracy and Tabitha tell me the tents are home to several families from all over the island, Kakaako, Kapalama, Chinatown, and Waikiki. The state has repeatedly offered shelter. So why are these families refusing the help?
We don't like the shelters. I cannot live with my family from just a backpack. That's all you're allowed is a backpack. And it's just a place to sleep. This is a place to sleep too. What's the difference?
The state's goal is affordable housing, eventually. But State Representative Tom Brower says there's something the government can do right now.
Right now, overnight, we can set aside some land, whether it's in Kakaako or somewhere else, and allow them to pitch their tents. That will go a long way in solving homelessness and removing campers where we don't want them, on the sidewalks and in some of our parks.
Brower says he's working with State Homeless Coordinator Scott Morishige. Meanwhile, the Martin family says they'll do what they can to help their old neighbors.
We had a chance, and that's all these people need is a chance.
I plan on following up with State Homeless Coordinator Scott Morishige on the latest update with the homeless in Kakaako. I'll let you know what I find out. Bridget Namata, KHON 2 News.